The smart car, possibly one of the most underrated EVs of all time. And I'm not just saying that because I own one. I mean, look at this beauty. Ain't she perfect? I'm charging my car right now at a local charging station. And I thought as I'm charging, it's time to tell you guys about my electric vehicle, the smart car, why I bought it, why I am now selling it, and why I think it's one of the best EVs on the market. The smart car is not an expensive car, and that is probably not surprisingly because of its small size. It's only two seats. It doesn't have a lot of room, and you certainly can't fit a fuck ton of people in it. When I first decided to buy this car, I was looking for an electric vehicle, and I looked top to bottom. You know, I looked at the Nissan Leafs, I looked at the Chevy Sparks, I looked at hybrids, I looked at Priuses, I looked at everything that I could possibly find, except for Teslas, since they were definitely outside of my price range. And this car is one of the only electric vehicles I could afford, and it's worth it. You can buy a newer smart car with less miles on it and a better battery than any other electric vehicle on the market. And in my experience, these cars are super dependable, really fun to drive, especially if you're in a city. If a parking spot is large enough, like wide enough, you could literally park perpendicular to the parking spot and you would fit just fine. I mean, I drive in DC all the time when I'm doing activism there, and having the smart car is amazing because I could basically park anywhere. My friends can't park. I don't have to worry about finding parking because I can just like pop up on the end of a street where there's just like a little space left, but not enough space for a large car, and I fit totally fine. And it's also really efficient in the city because you're constantly stopping and going in traffic, you're not driving very fast, you're not like accelerating very quickly, and all of that is super energy efficient for an electric car. So I love driving the smart car in the city. Now I'm gonna be honest with you, the smart car does not have a good battery range. It's nothing compared to the Tesla. Most electric cars are nothing compared to a Tesla. It hits about 60 miles per charge if we're combining city and highway. Because the smart car doesn't do great on long range trips, most EVs don't, but this car in particular doesn't because it has a small battery, it doesn't have a lot of range. So it really, I wouldn't drive it on more than like a 2-hour trip. And then if you did make it 2 hours, you'd have to make sure that wherever it is that you're going has a place that you could charge. The smart car obviously has a lot of limitations. It is a smaller vehicle. It's only really good if you're a single person or a couple. You do a lot of driving by yourself and you don't need all that room in the back. But even though it is small, it's surprisingly roomy. Like I could fit quite a lot of stuff back there because of its hatchback shape. So I've put 4 TVs back there before, and when I take advantage of this front seat as well, I can fit like a big, huge plastic tub container full of all of my activism equipment, and it all fits perfectly into this car. It's kind of like a clown car in that way because you could fit a surprising amount of stuff in here. And because this seat right here, this passenger seat, folds down, I fit a full carpet in here, a rug in here from front to back, just because of all of that space that it has back there. The smart car is super efficiently designed. The charging system is built into the back door back there, this gate at the very back. There is like a tire repair kit built into the floor, and there's lots of other hidden compartments and things that you like wouldn't normally notice, but you pay attention, you're like, oh wow, that's like really intelligently designed. That's a smart design choice there. And they kind of have to do that. It's almost like the tiny house of cars because it is a small car, a small space, and they have to fit a lot into it to make it functional. And I really appreciate that about any design, but especially a car design, because I do feel like a lot of times cars aren't really designed intelligently. So for as small as a smart car is, it really does hold a lot of stuff. And if you don't need all that extra room for extra passengers in the back, you're probably fine to use a car like this. Now where the smart car really shines and where I think it will work for most people is if you were a family and you're looking for a second car. If you already have a gas car that you can use for long trips, or a gas car that you can use to transport a whole bunch of people in your family, more than two people, then a smart car would be a great addition to your family, because the next car that you buy will be electric and obviously better for the environment. And then all of those small trips that you would normally do in your big gas guzzling car, you can do in the smart car. So if you need to go to the grocery store and you're just gonna go by yourself, you can take the smart car. If you need to run to a doctor's appointment, you can take the smart car. If you just need to commute back and forth to work by yourself and you don't need to pick up a bunch of people along the way, you can take the smart car. That all becomes even easier if wherever it is that you're commuting to has an electric charger nearby. So there are certain benefits in general that come from electric vehicles, and those benefits are not lacking in the smart car, even though it's a lot smaller than other EVs. One of which being that obviously it's really great for the environment, a lot better than fueling your car with fossil fuels, even if you're using fossil fuels to power the electricity that you're putting into your car, it's still better than filling your car up with gas. Electric cars are also really fun to drive. They have a lot of pickup, they're kind of zippy, they can go zero to really, really fast on the highway, a lot faster than most gas cars just naturally without even trying. In general, they're pretty easy to maintain. You don't have to change the oil, you don't have to fill them up with gas. You don't have to be visiting gas stations all the time. They don't have the same hardware as a like regular gas car would. So overall, that means that you have to do less maintenance. They're pretty easy to maintain. But of course, there are some limitations to having an electric car, and the smart car is not exempt from those limitations. One being the range, and the smart car does have a shorter range than some other electric vehicles. Not by much when you compare like older electric cars to the smart car, but the range is definitely shorter. It is a lot harder to take long distance drives with the smart car. You obviously need to be able to know where you're going to charge your car, and if you don't have a charger at home, you're gonna have to plan for that ahead of time. In the summer, I don't use the air conditioning, and in the winter I don't really use the heat either. It takes up so much of the battery power that it really isn't worth it to me to be using the heating and cooling. I mostly just like let the windows down, or in this car in particular I have heated seats, and the heated seats for whatever reason basically take up no power at all, so it's really easy to keep my body warm as long as I'm dressed warm when I have on the heated seats. And we get like pretty cold winters here, so those are some good things and some bad things that come from an electric car. No matter what car you have, those are just limitations to buying electric. But overall, the environmental benefits of having an electric car really outweigh the cons. Next to going vegan, owning and driving an electric car is one of the best things you can do for the environment. But it's also one of the most inaccessible things you can do for the environment, because electric cars are expensive. They are very expensive. And because of the charging issue, you have to have some type of home where you're able to charge. So either that's having some type of charging equipment outside of your house or close by in your neighborhood, or having some sort of outdoor plug where you can slow charge or trickle charge, as we call it. So financially, electric cars are really difficult for a lot of people to justify. But in the long term, people spend a lot of money maintaining and buying gas for gas cars too. So do they sort of break even? I don't know, it's kind of difficult to say. But here's what I will say. Smart car EVs are totally underrated because they are so much cheaper than most electric cars. You can get a smart car for about half of the price of a comparable electric car with less miles and a newer model. This is a 2014 smart car with almost 44,000 miles on it, with heated seats, with a moonroof, with a lot of added in extras in there. It has an aux port, all of this stuff. The Kelley Blue Book value for this car is somewhere in the range of 4,000 to about 6,000. I found it from a private seller online on Craigslist. I got a really good deal on it, and I literally have had zero problems with this car. I haven't taken it to the mechanic one time. I haven't had any issues at all. I have never owned a car in my life where I haven't had to at least, you know, throw $500, $800, $1,000 into it within the first year. And I haven't had to do anything for this car to maintain it. I haven't even had to pay to get the oil changed. This is just a sturdy, dependable little car. Like, it's everything that you need and nothing that you don't. It has just the right amount of space. It has just the right amount of accessories. There's radio, there's Bluetooth, there's heated seats if you need it. The one that I have has a little bit of luxury with the heated seats and the moonroof, but it's nothing extraordinary. It's just exactly what you need. And if you're shopping with your budget and the environment in mind, why would you go for anything else? It's so fun to drive. It's so like unique and funny looking because it's tiny and cute. It's great for the environment. It's great for your budget. You won't have to pay for gas. And if you're like me and you charge at all of these free places, you won't have to pay for charging either. And if you do pay for charging, you're gonna pay less than you would be paying for gas anyway. So it's still gonna be cheaper in the long run. My insurance is so cheap. I'll link it below if you guys haven't heard of it. It's called Root Insurance, and they judge your driving based on how you drive. They use your phone to like analyze the way that you drive and if you drive safely or not, and then they give you discounts based on that. So I found a really good rate with Root. So it breaks down to about $45 a month just to insure the smart car, and that's all that I pay. This has been the easiest, cheapest, best little car I've ever had, and I freaking love it. It is awesome. And the reason that I'm selling my car is not really anything to do with the smart, but it has more to do with the limitations of an electric vehicle and where I am in my life right now. The worry that comes with having a car and all of the financial burden that comes with having a car, because cars cost money. They're like, if you're trying to save money, don't buy a car. I mean, I get it. People have to have cars. Like, I have to have a car. I live in an area and my lifestyle requires me to use a car. But cars are expensive. There's always maintenance to be done. Insurance is expensive. Taxes are expensive. You have to get it tagged and titled. You have to get the registration renewed. There are all these different hidden fees that come up. And this car has been such a relief to have because all of those fees are minimized to literally the bare minimum. Like, only the essentials of what I have to pay are what I'm paying, and anything extra is going right to my savings account. So I kind of wanted to make this like ode to my car, this dedicated video to my car, because now that I am selling her, I call her Smarty, I'm really gonna miss her so much. She just is like so dependable. She takes care of me. She doesn't worry me at all. I always know that she's gonna be there and she's gonna work, and as long as I charge her, my girl is good. And I'm really sad to let her go. So thank you, Smarty, for taking care of me for these last 3 years. And this video is for you, Smarty. If anybody else is thinking about buying an EV, but they're worried about price, or they're trying to get a second car to supplement their family, but they want to pick a car that's more environmentally friendly, more sustainable, I highly, highly recommend the Smart Car Electric. It is so fun. It is such a great little car, so dependable, so cheap, so easy to maintain. Like, basically everything about it is good. I can't say anything but good things about it. I highly, highly recommend.